through your upbringing, you speak really positively about Adelaide, about the community, about feeling like you've been included. Did you always feel that?
Yeah, but I came from a very middle-class background. The thing that I have had issues with recently is an interesting one. It's that I feel like really minor things are getting conflated into the word racism when it's not necessarily racist. I think ignorance is difference. Is different to racism. When people say, oh, do you think, like, it's racist when someone mispronounces your name? I was like, no, of course not. Everyone's name gets mispronounced. Systemic racism is what happens to Indigenous people. It's like, it's horrific.
Yeah.
Unacceptable.
Systemic, yeah. I mean, Aboriginal people, they fear every time they go into the shop because they know the eyes are watching them.
Yeah. Yeah, that stuff.
Yeah, that stuff. And if you're walking down the street and you see a cop, you know, the fear comes in, okay, what's he going to say to me? What's he going to do?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
That sort of stuff. So that's, you know, that's where it makes Aboriginal people feel uncomfortable because they know that the eyes are watching them all the time, you know, and the media don't help it as well because there's no good stories about Aboriginal people in the media. It's all bad stuff. I've never seen a good media coverage of Aboriginal people on TV.
Yeah.
You take the sport out of it, and then what's the story about?
No, I know.
There's no story.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's no good story.
Derek's right there. He's, you know, really active in his community. So all the issues that he really likes to talk and educate people about are important issues. And I really enjoyed soaking that all up. I have acquaintances who have hauled me up on saying something. I've got quite a few Aboriginal friends. Like, because I was paying one of my mates out because he goes walkabout all the time. And, like, I've had a friend haul me up and go, oh, you can't say that.
But have you asked him, your Indigenous mate, have you spoken to him about it?
Oh, yeah, we pay each other out all the time.
Yeah, okay. Where you're saying that, you know how you're saying that your Aboriginal mate allows you to say that walkabout, but when you say it in front of around other Aboriginal people might get offended by it.
Is it a derogatory term?
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
I didn't know that. Yeah.
But I don't get offended by it. It's just uncomfortable when people say it when they don't know what it really actually means.
Well, I just understand it as a need to commune with nature and get away from the city.
It means that, he's gone, he's not coming back, he's lazy, unreliable, yeah. It's unreliable.
Okay. Well, I'm really sorry. I had no idea.
It was really humbling to be corrected about that and know that it was inappropriate for me to use. And he did it in such a nice way. And such a kind way.
Derek, apologise about that. That was my ignorance. Yeah.
Same with even a simple term like, them black fellas over there. And you say, well, you can't say black fellas. Mm. Only we can say black fellas.
It was really good to be able to apologise and know that, to just be a little bit more careful when I assume that I can use words that my Aboriginal friends use.
Okay, well, I've learnt something. That's good.